What's going on, guys? It's Lord Beardo from Loot Nation. I'm bringing you a war against Iraq. We are winning 67-47. We got the Duhas brothers at the bottom. Me with the heroic attack. My brother with the heroic defend. A lot of these bases didn't have the walls that were really that far upgraded, so it really didn't seem like a war that Loot Nation wasn't going to go ahead and take care of. Jumping on board here with Shlice, one of the co's from Loot Nation. He's going to grab the heroes. He is going to activate the clan castle, swing them all out to this left-hand side, and go ahead and eliminate those pieces of defense. All right, Shlice is going to come through here with all hogs. He does bring a couple of giants as an initial meat shield to grab a little bit of the fire. When you're running these hog armies, you also have to come with your heal spells. It is very important to drop the heals down, keep their energy up, keep their attacks going. A lot of these new anti-hog bases, you can tell now when there's anti-hog bases. You can see inside the bases where the Tesla coils are going to pop up, where you're assuming that there's going to be a lot of anti-hog things that are happening. So with the hogs, being that there is no, you know, guaranteed area to start your attack from because you're dropping your heal spells, doesn't matter where you bring them in, you just want to mainly drop them in an area of defenses that are all very tight, closely knitted. As you see up top there, he's got the air defense, he's got the wizard tower, and then you see they're going to run through that little hole. You know that's going to be where there is a spring trap, but then right under that, you got your expo, you got your mortar, you got wizard towers, and they're all close packed in there. That's why he brings everybody through. Keep the spells up, keep them going. You see he's got his giant still alive. All in all, it's going to be a nice little wrap up for him. He's got the level 5 hogs, bringing it strong, 3 stars, letting Loot Nation get to a little bit of a lead. These hog armies are definitely going to run you a lot of dark elixir, but you got to pay the price when you want to get the 3 star. Supercell put out an update, and now you can spectate a little bit. We see Tom here fighting Anmar, and he's got 2 stars right now, and as the fight will progress, you'll watch him throw up that 3rd star, and instead of compiling all 3 at the end, you can actually watch it go 1, 2, and 3, and they give you a whole new screen, as you see right here. So we're going to jump on board with Tom and check out that 3-star raid that he has. He grabs the clan troops, brings them off to the left side, surrounds them with the archers, takes them down nice and quick. Remember, don't forget to pull the clan castles out. He's going to put the giants up on the top area. He's obviously going for that 1 air defense, and he's got, this guy actually has all 3 air defenses in really bad spots on the outside. Looks like he probably just got into Town Hall 8. He has like a pretty new wizard tower. He's got some wooden walls up. So Tom picked a nice little fight here. He's got some dragons coming, a few hogs, mainly giants, and he's going to have those air defenses in nice, easy to get areas. And when you're bringing in these giant dragon armies, you really want to take the air defenses down. Now you see right here, he should have definitely put more troops directly on that bottom air defense, as it's going to take out that dragon. He could have put the hogs there, which would have been perfect. It would have taken out that air defense and then jumped right onto that wizard tower. Nonetheless, as you saw from the spectator screen, he gets the 3 stars. So let's see the finale here. Tom's army didn't seem like it costed too much elixir, so he's probably going to make out on this war right here. Like I was saying before, sometimes you don't really make out, but you do what you got to do to get the 3. So he comes in, cleans it up, uses the giants, dropping the healer spells, the raid spells, kept the king alive the whole time. These defenses are low, it's pretty weak 8, so he cleans up for another Loot Nation 3 star. Okay, so what I was trying to explain before, and now you can see perfectly, is with this new update, you'll see that Jeremy starts to fight here, can't say the guy's name, and he's got three blank spots for the star area. And as the fight continues to progress, you will see that it'll say 25% destroyed, and then all of a sudden a star will pop up. And then as the war progresses, as the raid progresses, you will see exactly what he goes ahead and accomplishes. Jumping right over to Jay Noob, we were picking on him a video or two back about not luring the clan castle out, and you see right here, he gets the job done, pulls him out, he's going to throw him over to the right hand side, go ahead and take those wizards down. He's coming through with the giants, he's brewed up a bunch of his own wizards, he's going to get the clan castle dropped with some level 5 wizards, which are going to help out. This clan didn't offer too much with the town hall 8s, they were all very premature. I advise maxing out through town hall 7 till you get to town hall 8, just because with the loot penalties you pick up for moving up town halls, you don't want to get yourself into a position where it's hard for you to make loot as a town hall 8, and then you're getting slammed by the town hall 9s and, you know, town hall 10s coming down every once in a while to make quick work of you and all your loot. So max out your town halls, do all your upgrades, do all your troops, especially your troops. It's really important you don't get that penalty for looting and then have a lot of trouble as you're in a, you know, premature 8 or 9. Moving quickly to Matt, another co. He is the leader of the Canadian crew inside of our clan. He is going to activate the clan castle, pull down the king and the queen, drop a lightning strike on top of the castle, eliminate almost the entire castle. You got one little nagging wizard going on there at the bottom, drops the king, hits him with the rage spell quick, takes out the heroes, and then he is going to be off to work, dropping one golem off the bat down at the bottom, trying to take some of that fire, doing the really expensive high-level meat shield with the high golems, and then bringing the hogs, coming full hogs all the way across the map. And this is a great little base to try to do this to. They only have one Inferno Tower set to single target. That's just not going to be what you want to do. You're going to want to multi-target and upgrade your Inferno Towers so that you can take down the hogs. Again, there's a lot of anti-hog bases out there with really good trap designment. You're going to want to go ahead and use that when you're getting up to the higher level here, or at least, you know, take some of their little pointers and put them into your own design. Try to get the big bombs upgraded inside and a lot of spring traps next to defenses that are connecting each other. And Matt's just going to clean this guy up. He doesn't have a very strong Town Hall 10 base at all. His walls are a little low. All the defenses were a bit low. But Matt just comes in with the Crusher and finishes up another 3-star raid for Loot Nation as we really start to pull the lead here against Iraq. We're going to check out Dath, who is our second highest member in Loot Nation. He grabs the king, grabs the queen, activates the CC, going to swing him down to the bottom portion of the screen, drop a little lightning spell on top of them, bring the heroes back over as they were running away a bit. He's going to drop his king down, rage through both the heroes, brings the queen for the same thing, and he's coming with the hogs here, so dropping your heroes against the heroes when it comes to the hogs isn't necessarily a bad thing. You want to eliminate them quick. He drops the freeze spell, great spot, holds up one of the Inferno Towers, which is set to single again, and he held up the Expo for a minute there. But what I was saying before about the heroes, when you are bringing the hogs and you know that they're coming from the same side of the screen that your heroes are going to be coming from, you know that the defenses that are going to be hitting them initially are all going to be taken out, and your king and your queen are pretty much going to do cleanup duty. When you're coming through with these level 5 hogs, you do not need much past putting enough of them down and making sure that you drop the heal spells on top of them before they get blown up or before they get sprung up in the air. So you want to keep the health high on them, drop the heal spells early, because you need the hogs in the end of the match here, as you see that they go, once all the defenses are completely down, they'll start attacking buildings, and this is what you're going to need to clean these matches up with these large spread out town hall 10s. So I got a little cute. I didn't go with my level 4 hogs. I tried to bring some dragons. I went up a bunch of spots to fight their 8. And I did merit myself the most heroic attack, but it was not the prettiest win. So, but here it is.
Yeah.